Sometime around 1972 or 1973, on one of our trips to Mexico, we came across a dog eating another dog. We had a friend who was incarcerated at La Cárcel de Mujeres in Santa Marta, located on the far outskirts of Mexico City. We caught the metro near the Zocalo, riding to the end of the line where we boarded a chicken bus colorfully decorated with swaying pom-poms and Bozo the Clown, or Jesus, or the Virgin Mary hanging in front of the driver, lighting up when the passenger pulled the cord to disembark. Somewhere past the corrugated tin and cardboard ghetto, we ourselves pulled the cord and began the last phase of our journey, crossing the large desolate field traversed by open sewage canals. It was in this place that became known as La Plaza de Puerto Muerto, with balsas full of everything from chicken to chocolate to soap to Tampax, and with money sweated to our feet, to discreetly smuggle into the prison, we came upon the dogs. It was there, perhaps inadvertently, no way premeditated, and certainly with no conspiracy, that Joan, Phyllis, and Janet showed me the way out of that strange park. sometimes glimpsing childhood, I come to you more than quiet. Silently I come with only a vision, with scarcely a feeling, a sense of how it was, how it could be, so quiet, even warm. The quiet turns to ice, all that was formed in space, this which has flowered, that which has bloomed or smelled up the air. I come to you to stare into your eyes, to play childhood games in the warm wrinkles of your flesh, meaning no harm, only that of loving. I come to you, my lovers, my love. My love, I do not know you any longer, my childhood friend, who will return not even my dying gaze. We who live separate, who die separate, what can we make together anymore? Our serious silent, our silent fear is not as quietly warm as the kiss we formed in space when our minds were young and we were scared not of dying but living alone.